Guys, just a quick spear gun tutorial. Spear gun I'll be using today is a Speardiver Stealth aluminum barrel, 100 centimeters. Just bought this gun and I'm deciding to rig a reel to it today. Rob Allen, 70 meters, 600 pound Dyneema, great reel. The first problem I had with this was the existing bracket, which I've already gone ahead and taken off, didn't fit the reel, and so I had a problem with that, but luckily it came, Rob Allen reels come with their own bracket. I've gone ahead and already pre-drilled two holes right under the line guide to fit this barrel, to fit the bracket, sorry. So I will go ahead and just screw in the existing screws that came with the reel. I just screw in that. And keep in mind, this gun costed me $210. It's a really great gun. I've already taken a couple of fish with it already. Some small snappers, just a couple of barracudas. I am planning on doing more rigging with this gun. Maybe a roll ahead. I know it has one single 19mm band, but I'm changing it to twin 16s because 19mm is very hefty. Oh, and another thing I should add, just to make the gun easier to handle, I took out the spear and the line and everything. It just makes the gun lighter, more easier to handle. You can't use the existing Rob Allen screw with the line guide. Another thing that you could do is just thread it where the muzzle bungee goes, but I already screwed in the line guide with a different screw and it took a lot of troubleshooting, but just finding the right screw will work fine. So now that our bracket is installed, we can clip on the reel. And Rob Allen reels are fairly simple to install. It's just a simple slide-on method, and the reel is in place. Now, set your drag, thread your line. And right through the line guide. Like so. So now our spear gun is hooked up with a reel, and now I'm just going to set the spear back in the shaft and tie that up accordingly. This is an open muzzle gun. Can opt to buy a different muzzle that is a closed muzzle, but I prefer open muzzle, and this gun does come with an integrated reel. I bought this gun from freedivestore.com and I'm very happy with it. The handle is much like a Pathos D'Angelo 1. Very nice. First time I went shooting, though, the loading butt did break off and I had to purchase a new one. I didn't know what was wrong with it, but it just snapped and I got really cut up. But I haven't had any problems with this one, so maybe it was just a defect. I couldn't tell you. All I know is that it hurt. So now that you have your spares, set your line up accordingly. I've already gone ahead and I have my bungee set up to my shooting line, because I do like to use a bungee. Just have to make sure your line is not underneath your shaft, else that will be a problem. Set up your line accordingly to the muzzle, as this is an open muzzle gun. I go once down around the handle and onto the line release, like so. And then with my muzzle bungee, which I have taken off of the muzzle. We tie a simple knot, and I'll show you how to do this. It's not very difficult. Just thread your Dyneema through the bungee. And here's how we do this knot. We go two times around the main line, like so. You need the tag end to be a little bit longer than usual. So two times around the main line, and then bend the tag knot, the tag in half, thread it back through, and cinch it tight. Now, this knot might look a bit precarious, but I've used it many times before. I've had strong fighting fish run off with my reel, run off with line on my reel, of course, and this knot has not given. And the simple way to just, if you need to replace your bungee, if you need to cut off a piece of line, just pull on the tag end, and boom. So once again, two times through the tag line, two times around the main line, sorry, fold the tag in half, thread it back through, cinch it tight. Very simple knot, very easy knot. I like it, it works quite well. And then I just get everything a bit tightened up just to make everything look better. Like so. Shit, just a bit more. Another trick I like to do is, because the line guide is so far from the muzzle hook, I take out some line and I thread it around the muzzle hook, and that way it just keeps everything tied up because the knot won't fit through the eye of the line guide. The knot is a bit thick. I might add. And so we cinch that up. Oops. Cinch this up tight. And then we right back around the line guide. The line release, sorry. Cinch up tight. And then I put everything under my line anchor, which is the part that I showed you in the previous video. Early on in this video. So now everything's rigged up accordingly. See? All my lines under, everything's connected, and now your gun is ready to go shooting. So in the next videos, I will probably be doing changing the rubbers, because as I said, this is one single 19mm rubber and it's very thick and very hard to use. I will be doing twin 16s, as I said, 16mm, and in later videos, I might be putting on a Mantis roller muzzle on this gun. So tune in for that. Thanks for watching.